Kí ló ń ṣẹlẹ̀? Ọmọ awo alfa. Ẹ káàsán sá. Ẹ káàárọ̀. It's too early. Bonani. It's already 10:30 in Sydney. Dr. Dorcas, how are you? You people, you don't sleep. You can request any song from me. Now play it. I'd ask you. Good evening, sir. It should be 12:30. I just define you. Are they come? I'm upcoming. I'm still upcoming. Thank you. I wanted to have a chat. Sorry, I've not been available for a few weeks. I was traveling then. I got strong. I was even admitted, but I thank God now. Ah, Sarah, how are you? How is Perth? I just mean at the glass house. Egg bow. Yeah. I want to be doing live Bible study later on after the election. Like, we share Bible together. I have a few ideas. And I want to relate it to African culture and our history in terms of how the white people came, took our culture, you know, exchange it with Bible, and the fact that yes, Jesus is the way, the life, right? At the same time, there's a way we need to understand the place of culture in whatever we do. I'm a Christian by religion, and I think everything I do I'm led straight from the Bible, right? But at the same time, I realize that there's quite a lot of misconception when it comes to African culture and the Christianity and even Islam, especially how the religion was passed to us. But that's story for another day. Today is Friday. I'm just jollificating here and want to hear people's view about the election. If you have a say, you can join me. I'm busy, but I'll keep the live. And I'll be playing some fella song. Yeah, I hope the people in Nigeria are able to. They will tell us to be the law of the land. Yes, so. So, I will just suggest, like, I want to hear people's view about the election. I was quiet intentionally. Because, yeah. You know, sometimes you don't know as much until you go really deep into this stuff. Like how stuff works, how politics works, how money works, how money circulates especially. And all these things we were not taught, right? We were not taught about money. We're not taught about money. We're not taught about life generally. This is my uncle's online. Ekarosa. I miss your call. I call back to via McQueen, la ro la lo doyin. Mo ti de pada si Australia. So, as I was saying, we're not taught how money works. We're just going to school. Someone like me, I used to brag, which does not make sense. I used to brag that I went to school, I didn't sleep from SS1 till I finished my high school. I never slept between 12 and 4. I could read for Africa. But I was reading, like, there's a way our curriculum was done, that it was done in such a way, like, for us to be employees or to serve others. Like, there's something I read, like, you know, in Nigeria, you have lithium, it's the new oil, you have gold, you have this, you have that. But children are never taught that in school. We're supposed to be taught how to mine our resources, how to maximize it from primary school. Because now we are being taught this and that, some geography that you don't need. We're taught about rock. Geography is good, don't get me wrong, it's my favorite subject. But we're taught some things in school that were really not necessary. Right? It wasn't really necessary. So, for example, I would have suggested, like, if we're in high school or in primary school, these things that were related to us, like Buhari's government, for example, intentionally shut down history throughout this period as the president of Nigeria. They didn't teach history in school. And that's deep. Someone like me, the reason why I stopped being coming out to talk, you know, before I used to do a lot of live, Nigeria this, Africa this. By the time I went into libraries and I started reading a lot about our history, there's too many things to mention. There's too many things. You are so hurt, like, there's so many things to see. Like, I know so much now, especially about our history, how things were forced on us. I went as far as finding the source of my name. Hence, that's why I put on LinkedIn, like, descendant of Oladeyede. I've seen some books that are just available in maybe 2 or 3 libraries in the world. There's a particular one that's only available in Munich, Stellenbosch, in MIT. And the other one is in the with the Queen. So, I was lucky enough to see that book. Koinshe Wego, it's like in leather. It was inscribed on leather. Was written by a German theologian. He was in Sierra Leone. So what he was doing was, he was interviewing people that were taken as slaves to Sierra Leone. And he was interviewing people that were brought from Sierra Leone to Sierra Leone. And that's how I knew the relationship between the Creoles and the Yorubas, the way we moved to Sierra Leone. There's a guy I read there, because if you need to understand those kind of books, you have to read it with other books. I was lucky enough, my parents studied Yoruba, so I really read a lot of Yoruba stories growing up, right? And because of that, I understand how language moved from Ibati, when it was Udiye to Adiye to Idiye, all those kind of transitions. So when I read this book, you could read from there, there was a guy who was taken slave from Elisha. So he documented why he was taken as slave. So he said he had a wife. He was married to the most beautiful woman in Elisha, and then he had 5 children. And then the chief there in Elisha said he wanted to marry his wife. This is a woman that already had 5 kids. So the guy said he refused. And because he refused, they sold him into slavery. It was really hurting. Mukasa, I read the story, and there's a lot of people that were documented like that, and how that then there's this, when I was reading about, I can check for the lady's contact. So I because of that, I was interested in this history, and I had to go to the US embassy in one country like that in South America. I won't mention the country. So I'm trying to read the message. So the lady, when I was reading about that particular country, I realized like there's a particular language in that country that was formed by people that were brought as slaves from different parts of the world. So you understand, I'm trying to look for the girl's contact. Yeah, because we had a long discussion and it was like they eat egusi, they eat everything like that. When I was in Brazil also, I was lucky enough to go to the Yorubas there, and I was shocked. The same way with Jamaica, where there is Abeokuta in Jamaica. There's a city called Abeokuta. As a matter of fact, I think this is available on YouTube, where some lady also went to document how the Yorubas that were taken as slaves to that side, they tried to make a city look like Abeokuta in its real self. Tonshi, they made Odogun. They made the way Odogun is when you go to Shukori, like that. And then you wonder when you read history book. Some of the things I found also reading history book is I found that the Egbas were supplying cotton to the UK during World War One, and the Egbas were referred to as a nation. So, but when you go to Abeokuta, you move from Oshiele to Itaoshin. I think that's end to end. You say like, is this all? How were these people able to do that? Or did something happen? Was the generation wiped out? You know, because the way they were said, for example, if you read the story of Idaume and the Egbas, the Idaume, now Republic of Benin, they used to come through Yewa to fight the Egbas, and the Egbas defeated them. You know, there was a time we had to use women to fight the battle. And then of course the Berlin Accord that now cut Benin Republic out of Nigeria, that separated us. That's why you still see there's a lot of kings in Benin Republic that are Yorubas, and there's a lot of people there that are Yorubas, but we are not as, I don't know, I'm careful with my English, we are not as whatever as the Hausas in terms of the Fulanis in Katsina are still well connected to the Fulani in Niger Republic. They are still like this, like the same. You can see that's why you see a lot of flows between Chad, Niger, and the north. But we don't do that a lot. There's a friend of mine from Togo, he's now in a lecturer in MIT, the Bawana. This guy, half of his language, sometimes if I listen very well, I'm able to understand it, and I'm like, ah, this guy, this is Yoruba adulterated. And the same thing with the Creoles that I said in Sierra Leone. And it's interesting to see how we have moved as Africans. And a lot of us are practicing, like, if you say you are a Christian, most of us are Christians because your parents are Christians. Muslim because your parents are Muslims. Now, faces change. We took the Pentecostal. Luckily, our parents, that's why they were able to localize the religion those days. But we didn't know why. Our forefathers were doing, you see those churches, those Orthodox churches, they have seats in front where these men are Ogbonis, the Oluwawos. They were also in church. But you see, as we progressed towards Pentecostal, we castigated them. We saw them as evil people, you know. But then we didn't know why, because these people were defenseless. That's all they had. And for me, when I read the story of the Egbas supplying cotton to the UK before 1914, that Nigeria was amalgamated, I was shocked. The same thing goes to what I wrote about recently, like a few months ago, about Ajala the Traveler. The story at home is Ajala died a puppet, like he died of stroke. Yes, he died of stroke or something like that, but it wasn't reported like Ajala died because there was no much health support for him. But here in Australia, Ajala is an icon. As a matter of fact, he was married to an Australian, and the launch I'm doing now is looking for the children, obviously will now be maybe grandchildren. Adela was in Australia in 1954 when he wrote his book. So I knew about the book from that, from the Munich library where I read about the palliative course that I mentioned earlier. I've known from 2016 that there's a book by Adela and I was looking for it and I knew it was only available here in Sydney. So of course I never knew I was going to be in Australia to stay. So I went back to South Africa, I was reading it, blah, blah, blah. And then when I got here, I was in Perth, later found my way here. I read the book, like actually reserved. The book is, you can't take it out of the library, it's those reserved collections. So I kept the book in my name on the shelf. I just, you can do that. I kept it permanently for like 2 months. Because there was a lot of information there. This guy went to Russia. And he went everywhere. He went to Russia, went to Israel. He went everywhere. So he was documenting his journey. He's a very great man. But the story at home is different. He's a very great man in such that he was documenting the experiences of Nigerians abroad, African abroad. He was on Vespa, on a scoot. So on Tok Tok, or what do you call it? I don't know, whatever you call it in your motorcycle. He met the head of India, the head of Palestine, and he was documenting. For example, he spoke about what Nigerians were facing in Russia as early as 1949, which is exactly the same thing. When I read about the last chapter is Australia, everything he said in 1956 about Australia, just copy and paste, is what is happening now. I'm not like, there's a lot happening. So for me, I know we've lost library, like there's not a lot of people in the library going to libraries to read more, but I just want to encourage people to try and read about your history. It's very, very important. You change your perspective about life, you'll be more matured. You realize there's nothing you are facing that someone has not faced before. Like sometimes as I'm speaking like this, like it's just like when this election was coming up, it was close to those 79 and 83 elections in Nigeria. At the same time, there are some unique differences. So because I knew the role that experts and people played in those elections, that's why I personally decided to be quiet. The only person I knew, like I tried to read sometimes ago why Awolowo was never the president of Nigeria. So I knew the way we feel now, divided, like we want a change. Everyone wants a change. I mean, you're tired of the norm in terms of this set of people. And for me, literally, I've said it everywhere. I'm fluid, dynamic, but I stick to my rules and values. So when the APC were doing their primaries, I literally was rooting for Osinbajo, right? Not because of anything, but because I understand like sometimes there's need for proximity to power before taking power, which is the problem that I think it was Gowon that had those days. Gowon ruled for 8 years, and because it wasn't really, there was more much of proximity to power for Gowon when they took over from the government. That's why I think it was Buhari that pushed him out those days, and then Buhari took over, saying he was there for indiscipline, whatever. But because I know that, so I was like, okay, Osinbajo, at least he's close there. I'm not close to him, I know him, but he's been there. There's bias, people say maybe he'll be used by cabal or this or that. It's not my concern. But I was just telling you my favorite. So I don't even mind Anamichi as president. Because after speaking to people that come from Port Harcourt, I realize it's more like they are Binga Daniel. How Binga Daniel was to Ogun State. So, and he did well in terms of completion of the work that Jonathan started when it comes to the rail. But when Osinbajo even came distance last, I mean, distance third, or how do you say the English? I just kept quiet, like, old Titan. So for me, I didn't really have, like, who do you support? So I left it in the hand of people, like, support who you like. I have reservation about the two candidates. Of course, I'm not going to vote for Atiku. There was a guy that dragged me on LinkedIn saying he had a vision. He had a vision that Atiku became the president. So, because I was doing some polls on Nigerian president. So, and the guy, Ufe Womipa, but that's for that. But I just want to encourage people that what this election has shown us is election can't, I mean, vote can't. And nothing is impossible. If you really, really, if you really, really want to change Nigeria, it's actually possible. If there's a lesson from this election, that's it. But let's leave election out. I'm just checking out on people. How are you doing? It's my first live in almost a year. How is everything on your side? I'll just be here chilling. If you enjoy my music, fine. If you want me to change it, you can tell me to change it. Thank you so much, sir. I really appreciate. Thank you so much. So, it's very important. For me, I kept my head up. There's a lot I've been exposed to in Nigeria. There was a girl that dragged me because I said, congratulations, I assured you. I never said, I never campaigned for him. I could have if I wanted money, but I didn't. But I just said, whoever I need to declare, it's okay. Okay? The guy dragged me, blocked me everywhere. I just laugh. Like, this one doesn't know anything. This is life. You need to be careful. We want our country, but you have to be very wise in how you do your stuff. Just be careful. Because some people are very ruthless. And I was telling the girl, like, she was asking me, like, what have you done to Nigeria or for Nigeria? I said, me. So I was like, before I even end the name African Union or Mr. Nigeria, you'll be shocked. I said, have you read my book? She said, no. I said, then forget about it. That means that I wrote a letter to fight the coin because of Nigeria. Is it me that celebrated the birthday for the guy that made the Nigerian flag without getting any cover from Nigeria? So there's a lot of other things like that. I was sure, like, is it because I give scholarship, like my scholarship scheme? Is that why I think I've contributed to Nigeria? I just shook my head. You get to a point where you realize, like I was still giving a speech somewhere yesterday and I said I'm going back home. And they were like, I said, no, this is not my country. I only came for a limited contract period and I'm going. For me, there's no year I've never been in Nigeria. I've been in Nigeria every year since 2013, every year. Except 20, which year was? No, I went to 2020, even during COVID, no. So that's how much. It's not a waste of money. It's just something that's different. So I know there's a jackpot syndrome, everybody that is running out of the country. But when you get to a stage in life, you realize, like, there's nowhere like home. Nowhere, no place like home. Do your best, secure yourself, whatever you can do. I understand the system is wrong, horrible, not supporting. It's tough, right? But never ever teach your children that you can't go back home, you never go back home. No, it's very wrong. Nigeria is home. There's no way like Nigeria. See, I left Nigeria very poor. I went back to Nigeria as an expat. I saw a different Nigeria. So it's where you know. Nigeria is God. I'm not supporting the disparity between the very rich and the very poor. That's not what I'm saying. I'm just saying there's a lot about Nigeria that needs to be unlocked and that will unlock. I promise you, I do it soon. I mean, this particular government, whoever wins, either they come back and say B wins or they say it's too good, they will, that, whatever. So I'll definitely join hands with the government. And yeah. Before, I used to think like politics, but now I realize, like, you can actually make impact a lot. Yes, I have my own schemes that I do to help people, but not just help, I think we need to start thinking like how to create, I don't want to call it generational wealth, but I just want to say there's something that we need to do in terms of sustainability. There's a lot of things we don't have in Nigeria, and there's a lot of things we also have in Nigeria or in Africa generally. So I always tell people, never ever say, never go back home. No, don't do that. You need to do, because I can't imagine, my surname is Craig, for example. I can't imagine my child being, let me say I name my child John.
John is evil, baby. Okay, let me say Rock.
I name my child Rock. So Rock Craig. We'll be black. I'm black. I'm very black. And he can never be white. Even if you marry white people, my blood is strong. At least to the fourth generation, there will still be traces of blackness or Africanness. Then people will ask them questions. So they need, my children will need to understand. I say my children will go to school in Nigeria, and I mean it. That's the truth. I'm even going back home, so I never left. I was only shuffling between the two anyway. So I'm just encouraging people, don't give up. You can't give up on your country. If you give up on your country, then you give up on yourself. What is this? Why would you give up on your country? Because of what? Because of collecting pounds, have you collecting dollars? How much is the money you're collecting? But then don't let your children get lost. And speak language to your children. I'm begging you, please, speak. I get really frustrated. I'll need to, in the next 4 minutes, I won't talk again. I'll just leave the video on. It's hot, so I need to put on this. So, for me, it's, speak language to your children. Your own language, go. Because we can't lose it, my friend. What else do we have? If all of us leave. I'm not saying we should not leave. We'll leave, but plan to go back. I beg you. That's fine. On that note, you can ask me any question you want to ask me. I'll just be here playing music. Let me see if I can change this one. On pin tuba. Can we live and see? On pin tuba. I want to play a song, which is one of my favorite songs. It's Kunko Bello. It's very artistic. So, we need change of government, we need change of people. We need people to believe the country. Yeah, I know, but we just need a good president. We just need a good leader. A good leader and a good leader means people that are not accidental. Everybody that has been leading Nigeria has been accidental. They never prepared for it. They were not prepared for it. If you check my governor, for example, the guy never wanted to be governor. He was just contesting for Senate or House of Rep. Opportunity came. You need to prepare. I still believe you need to prepare. And preparation doesn't mean you have to be counselor because you lose your value along the line. You can't be in politics for 20 years in Nigeria and still remain the same. You want to tell me, is Oshiomhole the same? Yeah, when I say prepared, you need to be prepared. Yeah, you need to be prepared. I think I have one of my books here. This one, where I was writing, I was given the opportunity to lead. What would I do? I say I'll adopt the retirement package of South Korea. That's why I like this guy, Peter Obi. I didn't vote for him, but I liked him because of his exposure. He did something. I was just smiling because I did that. As young as I am, when I was in Korea, South Korea, I documented how they treat their retired people, the system. In Germany, I documented how they use their health system. The health system is really good. And then,
so in those places, and for example, as old, or not old, as low in class as South Africa may be, there's something about their research, educational research system. It's not as good as that, but then I read about it, I wrote it down. So like I had this template that we can use if I was called up. Of course, an energy from another country. So when I saw this guy going to Egypt saying he was learning how it works, it may be political gimmicks, but the truth is, I think that's very important. You need to learn how things are done elsewhere, and then you can apply it. Of course, not copy and paste. That's the problem that Nigeria had with this cement energy stuff. You just copy what they did in Egypt. You want to copy and paste. Then I'm all right. Okay, so for me, I want to thank everybody that has joined this live. I'll be quiet now. I gotta work. I'll just be here. If you want to ask me anything, Project Didi Labash. I told you my brother is in Manchester, right? Maybe in December. I want to come to UK now. Show me the Queen and die. Can you see me now? Don't know I see me. Ah! Now you mean eat you lower shah? Goodbye. Sorry. Shan go where? I love my son. Mission won't go to leisure. What can you say about Ashiwaju? Obviously, he's old. But age is not the reason to determine. Let me introduce this. In terms of. I'm in New York. Excellency, long time. So. For me, Ashiwaju, I think people say he put the right hole in the right peg. I think he's smart. I've met him before, long time ago. He's very smart and intelligent. I can't say much about him because I'm not sure how strong his will is. But he showed something in this election. Sometimes you would have helped a lot of people, okay? And you be hurting you, like now you need them, you need their help, but they all turned their back on you. Like, it happens a lot in life. I'm sure it has happened to all of you. For the first time, somebody said, dude, I've helped you guys, you need to come out and help me back, right? And that's it, defined a new system of human relationship in the sense of sometimes you help a lot of people, and when you need them, they'll turn their back on you. Now, Ashwaju did something that he was like, he came out publicly and said, dude, I've helped you. Come and repay me my help. You know, we used to joke, like, when you help people, you get receipt. Now he came back, because normal Yoruba people, Yoruba, we are always like, Yoruba, we are corny. We are corny people. Not corny in terms of evil, but corny in terms of, you people hurt you. Instead of you to tell them, you'll be quick, but for the first time, found somebody that hit the nail on the head. So that for me is a star. It changed that narrative. But because I said it's old, because I said I felt like I wish I could sit down with him. Because Nigeria is complex. Nigeria needs a don and a crazy person. And because Nigerian problem is complex, like I said, we need someone who can give 100% and has limited alliances. That's where it's tricky for me. So I don't know how innovative he is, because he's been there for long. Except because that's the problem we had with Buhari. Buhari came with the mentality of 1985, right? Everything Buhari was doing, especially when it comes to the downstream sector and the upstream sector of Nigerian oil and gas, you will see like everything he did would have worked in the 80s. But he was stuck in the 80s. This is 21st century. It's a different ball game entirely. So that's my fear for Ashwaju. Like, will he not be stuck in the past? Yeah, they said he will put people. Who are the people he will put? Is it not still Elrufai? I don't know. I know that Obasanjo did something in terms of using the best brain, the Konjo Wealas, the Dora Kunili, so I'm hoping like maybe if he has that, if he's banking on that, maybe he can work. Maybe, because someone like me too, I'm open. I'm also open. I think I have enough expertise gathered now to move things forward radically. But yeah, so that's my view about Ashwaju. Like I said, I was supporting Ashwaju. It was very hurtful for me when Ashwaju didn't win. And yeah, I wish there's a trial period, which there's none. About the health, all those things, Nigeria has money. They'll fix itself. See Buhari now. It was old. But the only problem is the fact that the downside to the fact that he said, I've helped you, and those people had no choice than to come through for him is, now we have a problem. It becomes torn. We are setting the narrative of turn by turn in Nigeria. Because he pulls through now because he said it's my turn, right? Then who knows the set or the number of people that has been lined up, right? There's a video I watched of Awolowo. You know Awolowo that said Atiku was being raised in Gongola to be the president of Nigeria. Do you imagine? Like, can you imagine? That's like 1985, 86. And they said Atiku was being raised president of Nigeria, 1985. Awolowo or something like that. I think I watched that video. So, and Atiku maintained that till 2023. So, who else is being raised? Or who else has been nurtured, or who else has been promised to be the president of Nigeria? So that's the problem of Tonton then would take out expertise, would take out capability, it will take out, yeah, less, it will take out, forgot the name of the word, like competency. But there's a kind of philosophy that says, let the best of us lead us. And like, we just need a decisive, radical president. Very important. That is active and alive. We need the president to be alive for Nigeria to work. We can't afford weakness at any point. There's no one that can't use expertise. You can summon the best brains in this world to be at different positions. But Nigeria has been wired around the president, such that the president's body language. You see what happened now? See what happened with the old Naira notes? How we were doing as a no man's land. Somebody woke up, said there is an old note, and president came out, disobeyed the court order. Like, the president came out to be saying she's using veto power for currency regulation. Like, and the whole country followed the president. Even when the Supreme Court said, okay, oh, yeah, I'm not gonna spend the money back. People were like, we're waiting for the president to talk. So that shows you, like, and this, even the governors, you see, I'm Malen, who do this, the governor said there's going to be environmental at a particular day. People will be. So Nigerian has been wired because we had a long time period of military rules. So people have been wired to obey the man at the center. Obey the man at the center. So sometimes people don't even know that they do have a choice. But do you even have a choice? That's the problem. So yeah, I don't know. I just wish him well. If they call me, anybody, I don't talk to him before. Anybody that reaches out to me, I put myself out there. Anybody that reaches out to me, and I'm not the only one. Like Bible said, like when Elijah said, I'm the only one. God told him that when there are 700 other people. So for me, I know I'm not the only one that is custodian of wisdom, genius, or intelligence, or capability, or zeal, the charge, the confidence, or the goodwill. There are a lot of other people too. So I'm just encouraging people, find something to do. Let me change the music for the benefit of people that I know. I see a lot of my friends that are not Nigerians are online. I'll try and change the music. Yeah, I've actually set up everything to be. So yeah, I think in politics there's a waiting time. Yeah, so that waiting is my problem. This waiting is my problem. I don't think Nigeria have the luxury of time. We don't have a system that supports any weak person to be the leader. Because remember when Buhari was sick for a long time, nothing was happening in the country. That's when Naira became what it became. It's a pleasure meeting you. I've seen your impeccable. Ah, they have started. Loriro, I've seen your impeccable CV and it's encouraging. Loriro, thank you, sir. Same to you. Kasibia, thank you, sir. Same to you. Okay, so what does anyone have for me? Oh? You don't know what's becoming money. So yeah, I'm not talking. So this is 13. The next 70 minutes is a silence period. Let me look for a good song so that we can enjoy it together. Let me play Nina Simone.
Yeah.
How can Nigeria be a better country? That's a complex question. It's too complex for me to help you. You can tell me what do you feel Nigeria needs? That question is very complex. You want Igbo worker? Yes, I do listen to him. You have a lot of me and you, we share a lot of things together. You want Igbo worker, I'll pay Igbo worker. I'm looking for my favorite song. Woman, you are crazy or something like that. That's my favorite Igbo worker. No, I'm not in Igbo worker mode. Let me continue with nursing. I need to work. Let's go to Angwood. But many people may not know this. Let me play Backstreet Boys. If I listen to T-Bone, I'll end my work. Yeah, you man, you must be crazy. That's my favorite. We should talk more in inbox. So we share a lot of philosophies. Yeah, I know. Yes, I remember. You wanted to kill me now, so that's why. But I was, like I said before, I was traveling for a while. I just came back home. So I was in Africa until 2 days ago. This is my gym reminder. I'm going to learn from my Lolita. I'll discuss with you because I've seen your work. It's really impressive. The fact that we share a lot of philosophy together, I think we need to revisit our discussion. You catch me. think she'll kill him. I don't play people. Kill him, she'll see. One project is sharing with TV. Yeah, then she. Wrong. I'll be staying in London. She didn't see me, she'll be staying in London. Career path. Can do it now. Book a session with me. Sure you want to pay me. Let's do it live. Ask me what you want. Otherwise, because my weekend until second week in April is fully booked. So, not this one. So, I think the Excel is so powerful. We can talk here. If you want to join me live, hit me. The methodology is what? We can do it here. We should have time. Oh, someone was trying to join. Sorry, I didn't see. Why did you request? Oh. I don't know, you didn't know my story. You should read my story. It's available everywhere. Online, on my website, on YouTube. Yeah, I'm here for a while. I'm in exile. That's why. I tried to add you. Everyone watching was tap to see. Why are you outside Nigeria? I've answered the question. Thank you, Jai, Mr. Ashim. Yo, mama, you answer clean. This lady, mommy, totally off. Sent me something. So everyone watching will see you on the tap a question to answer. Oh, multi tap. So she had a request on the name below. Yeah. So I answered the question. My years overseas are almost done. I was sent out of Nigeria. Oh, I didn't know so many people have asked this question. I'm sorry. What are the inputs? Put them on the norm. Specific input data inputs 1, 2, 3. Okay. And this is the question they use. And then the spot question they use. I think it's fine, I'll just give them a go. Yeah. Do what you love. It will bring you money. So that you can do what you don't love. Just to earn a pay. First make money. You need sustainability. Because if you don't really have back support. Oh, checking in. Why is it highlighted? Good day. Okay. So, PSSC card network model.
time around 30 minutes calculation. Who's through here? Oh, big boy, it's a big boy now. Should be 2022 data. Not 2020. Last year, not this year. Okay, I'm excited.